This video will demonstrate the microsurgical resection of a lateral parietal arteriovenous malformation. Patient was in her late 30s. She presented with headache and also complained of impaired memory, information processing, and math functions. The arteriovenous malformation was discovered incidentally. Her neurological examination was completely normal. Here are her MR images showing the AVM in the lateral parietal region just behind the somatosensory cortex. It sits in the postcentral sulcus as seen on the image to the left. The AVM is seen on the coronal view here with extension down into the depths of the parietal lobe. Her cerebral angiogram in AP and lateral views shows dilated and quite large middle cerebral feeding vessels that come from the angular territory and feed the AVM from anteriorly and inferiorly. You'll also notice a very large dilated draining vein, which is indicative of the high degree of arteriovenous flow through this AVM. AVM grading revealed this to be a Spetzler-Martin grade 3 AVM with 2 points for size and 1 point for eloquence. The Lawton-Young grade is also a 3, with 2 points for age and 1 point for a non-ruptured AVM. Her supplemented Spetzler-Martin grade was 6. Here is an illustration showing the patient position and the location of the AVM. Surgical strategy consisted of a craniotomy over the lateral parietal region, exposure of the draining vein to the sagittal sinus, identification of feeders in the interparietal and postcentral sulci, occlusion of MCA feeders from the lateral border, occlusion of ACA feeders from the medial border, white matter dissection along the anterior border that respected the postcentral gyrus, careful preservation of the medial draining vein throughout the dissection, and after resection, indocyanine green video angiography to confirm absence of shunting. Here is an overview upon opening the dura. The superior sagittal sinus is at the bottom of the field, and the ear is at the top of the field with the nose to the right. The early steps of the dissection are focused on identifying these large middle cerebral feeding arteries coming into the lateral border. Once these are seen, they are cauterized to reduce the flow through the nidus. Next, the attention is turned to developing these margins between the borders of the AVM and the adjacent gyri and sulci. You see this AVM had beautiful sulci with these very large feeding vessels that came up through them. And as I trace them to the border of the AVM, I take them right at the edge of the nidus. It's important not to take these too distant from the AVM because sometimes they loop and turn out to be bystander arteries. I'm going along the posterior margin of the AVM right against this very dilated draining vein. The draining vein is much more fragile and needs to be carefully protected, but by dissecting in this plane, you can see that it opens up this space underneath the vein where a lot of the feeding vessels are coming into the nidus. I'm lifting the vein with my sucker in my right hand, rolling it away from the cortex and developing this dissection plane. I'm on the other side of the vein. I'm finding the anterocerebral artery feeders on that medial surface, and this helps to finalize some of the arterial contribution. Here's a deep middle cerebral artery coming in from the inferior aspect. You can see I've traced it up the sulcus, the interparietal sulcus, and I've taken it right as it enters the nidus on that deep border. Again, I'm using my suction to lift the AVM and show myself the plane underneath. Now is the time to go across this anterior border. We know that the AVM is very close to the somatosensory cortex, so it's important to really hug the AVM tightly. You can see that I'm making my peel incisions here as close to the AVM as possible. And as I get into the parenchyma, you'll see the nidus to the left, and with some retraction on the nidus, you can see some separation plane developing. Here, the inferior-anterior aspect of the AVM dissection is being developed, and the AVM is peeling away very nicely from that anterior border. The AVM is rolled out completely now. and all that remains is this large vein keeping it connected to the brain. So I'm using my cautery to shrink the vein. By shrinking it, I can now transect it. And now the AVM is completely free, and I can remove it. You can see a very clean dissection with preservation of that somatosensory cortex. And indocyanine in green shows that there's no further shunting in any of the draining veins. Here's our final overview showing that the one plane of dissection through the parenchyma was on that anterior border against the somatosensory cortex. This is a great example of a lateral parietal AVM that lives in this lateral surface of the parietal lobe. It's fed primarily from these feeding arteries from the middle cerebral artery, which include the angular artery and the temporo-occipital artery. Our particular AVM had some feeding also from the anterocerebral artery. You'll also see the anterior parietal vein, which is the likely vein draining our AVM as well. The patient tolerated the procedure well. She had a mild transient apraxia in her right hand that quickly resolved. She was discharged home on postoperative day 2. Here is her postoperative angiogram in a lateral and oblique view, showing that the AVM no longer fills and the uninvolved bystander arteries are all nicely preserved. In conclusion, this case demonstrates that extensive subarachnoid dissection is needed to differentiate feeding arteries from bystander arteries before engaging the AVM. Parietal AVMs typically have terminal feeding arteries rather than en passage or transit arteries. These terminal feeding arteries can be occluded at the margin safely. Early dearterialization of the AVM through these larger subarachnoid feeders facilitates the subpeal white matter dissection along eloquent borders, which should be saved until the end. Nidal retraction away from eloquent cortex with your sucker hand helps to maintain a tight dissection plane that protects eloquent function. Thank you.